Because milder air holds more moisture, can hold more moisture. So sometimes if the temperatures are just a few degrees warmer in the winter, well, what does that mean? Instead of 25, it's 28. Or instead of 30, it's 32. It can mean more snow. So that, don't let that fool you. But this is El Nino, which is the top graphic here, and La Nina. These look like fish as you look at them, but they're not. This is South America right here. There's Ecuador. And this is the surface water temperature in the Pacific. So there's a core of warm water. These are the 10 strongest El Ninos right here. You get this ribbon of warm water over the Pacific. But this coming winter, we're expected to have a La Nina, which is cooler water on the surface, okay, in the Pacific. And what does that do? Well, it changes the jet stream pattern, changes the pattern a little bit, and we can, you know, we can have a milder winter here. So we'll see how that all works out, and we'll be tracking it for you. A dry weekend, rain Sunday night, and lasting into the morning commute, I think, on Monday. But just about rain just about every day next week. I think Thursday we might have a break, but then that's about it. So I looked at it. I think really Thursday may be the day when we don't have much rain. Clouds will prevent the first frost for us, but maybe just over the border in Massachusetts, they might actually have a frost in some communities on Sunday morning. It stays mild for now for this week, and there are the rain chances. Look at that as we go through the week. Yikes. You know, Tuesday's a really wet day as this low pressure system moves in. We'll show you that. We do have a low that's forming along a front here off the mid-Atlantic, and that's going to push south of us and not bother us this weekend, but it will keep us in the clouds and may give a couple of showers skirting the coastline. Then the next system is going to miss us. This is actually the beginnings of the storm system that is going to start forming here. It comes out of the Rockies, and it starts to form in the plains and spin up into a low pressure area. And ahead of it is this warm front that develops, and it extends all the way into New England. So that divides the cool air to the north, warm, moist air to the south. And anytime you get these air masses clashing, that's where you get the clouds and the rain. And this low will track pretty much due east right along that front and push in here. So as we look at the rain, it pushes off to the north on Monday briefly. But then more comes in on Tuesday, and it's with us on Tuesday night. It spins around. It's still showery on Wednesday. And then finally on Thursday, it starts to move out. But here comes the next patch of rain right on its doorstep. So as we look at the rainfall, this is Sunday morning. We go to Monday morning. We could be approaching half an inch in some places. But then as we get to Tuesday morning, we're over an inch in many locations as that the core of that low pressure system comes in. And when it's all done by Wednesday morning, we might have 2 inches of rainfall. So we haven't had that in a while. So get the rain gear ready. 59 on Saturday, lots of clouds. 7-day forecast shows 62 Sunday, blend of sun and clouds. Monday, it gets wet at the end of the day. Actually, early in the day, it's a little wet, but it's mostly dry. Tuesday is a wet day, lasting into Wednesday. And I said, maybe Thursday we'll get rid of that raindrop and keep it dry. Back to you.